I grew up in Eisenhüttenstadt, a small town in the east of Germany. And as everybody knows, it was a communist city and we couldn't get anything there beside the stuff that the government allowed us to listen to. So there was no R&B music on vinyls to get. So we had radio stations and we had to tape the music, and it was not easy to get a good source to get books from the West. And after the war came down, it was the opposite of that. So it was much more than one could listen to and read through and go to in theaters and so on. And but I wanted to be fast, so I had to go to a place where I could get everything in the highest quality and in a short moment. And this was New York. So they have great classical music. I was into classical music that time a lot. I could get great jazz, R&B, hip hop. So I was there and spent a long time and enjoyed it very much. In the 90s, I had no money at all and I couldn't play music. And to live, I had a few different opportunities, being a waiter or whatever. But I came from Eisenhüttenstadt and could work with metal. So I went to the Bronx and built those small cowbells. And you needed cowbells in those days to make a good hip-hop beat work. And so I could sell them in Manhattan and live. When I came back from New York from studying drums, I was again a musician. I played in different bands and music of the band members or of different composers and my music. And then I met a guy and we founded the Dresden Symphonica, and I was back in the orchestra world again. And I got approached from different bands to write for them orchestra music, because they saw me as a classical musician. And I wrote arrangements for strings and orchestra for bands like Rammstein, the Pet Shop Boys, Polarkreis 18, and Fourier Quartet. But it was all just arranging their music. And I wanted to write again my music and be a musician with my own music, and wanted to play and write, and this is what I do now.
Sven and I started to collaborate for one reason, and that's because of the Pocket Symphonies. He has a background that is very, first of all, distinguished in various genres, not only jazz, classical, and pop, but he seems to be good at all of them. I was extremely interested to do this, plus to have the opportunity to do it with the Fourier Quartet.
We were very, very happy when he came to us and asked us to take part in his first debut album as a composer. So we said yes straight away. Even we didn't know what we said yes to, but we knew if it's going to be with him, there's a good chance that it's going to be good and fun.
I wrote 12 orchestra pieces. They are short as songs. 3 to 4 minutes length. They are ready to wear and put in the iPod and listen to between two subway stations or in the traffic or in today's life. You want to carry the music with you and you don't sit in the stereo cross at home. And that's why I call them pocket symphonies, because you can take them with you. And you don't have to go to a concert situation where you sit for hours and listen to a symphony. And this is a symphony to go. And that's why it's Pocket Symphonies. Writing 12 Pocket Symphonies is, first of all, a very lonesome process where I sit down with just paper and a pen and try to write the music down straight to paper out of my mind. And I don't use any instruments, because I think when I create the music in my mind and write it without the instrument, then it's the purest translation of my feelings. And instruments would give me wrong impressions of what I would like to tell because of the special sound or the special character of the instrument. And so I'm free to translate my feelings into music. Pocket Symphony number 2 probably reflects in the best way what all the 12 symphonies try to tell. It's people in dark situations, in a melancholic situation, and without any way out, but they have a deep longing for better days or for bringing light into their dark moments. And I personally love music that is kind of a remedy against those feelings and dark feelings, and I can't even listen to music that doesn't give me that key to find the way out. And I hope very much that my music can achieve that.
Well, he's, as a composer, I would say, very unique, simply because he is a performer himself. A lot of composers aren't performers. I mean, he plays percussion. And, he, for example, on one of the pieces, this Eisenhüttenstadt, he wants to play the mallet instruments. So, in fact, he will be on the CD itself, and that's great to have the composer playing something on the CD. Besides that, he's very versed in various genres, and he is very open-minded. And he doesn't write in a specific style that is maybe noticeable yet, because you hear so many different styles on this CD. However, if you listen to enough of his music, you realize that he has a very specific style.